Welcome to Whisky.com, where fine spirits meet. My name is Lüning, Horst Lüning. I'm the master taster of Whisky.com. And today we taste a Edradour whisky called Straight from the Cask. 10 years old and 56.5 ABV. That's a lot. And this bottle has just 0.5 liters, so it's a little smaller than the normal bottles with 0.7 liters or 0.75 in the US. This particular bottle was distilled on December the 4th, 2010, and matured in sherry butt, in the sherry butt 407. So this is straight from the cask, a single cask. And it was bottled on January 22nd, 2021. And the number of bottled had been 894, well, more than the typically 700 something, because smaller volume. This kind of bottles from Edradour are quite old or established in the market, and in former times you had a very rustical appearance of this wooden box. It was very rough on the outside, and there was sawdust in it and some very, very natural. But now they have well planed wood, and it's extremely well finished, and the only rural parts left over is here a banderole at the cork or at the neck of the bottle, which had been has been in former times. I think it was some where some natural plant fiber something. So it was woven or yeah. So and this is now a paper banderole. Yeah. The most important thing of a bottle is the content. Sherry and astonishingly no alcohol. Ooh, wonderful. So it's so dark, it's so deep in color. It's cask strength and therefore it's not diluted with water. So this is natural color from the cask. It's very, very dark amber. And it's not that oaky, chalky, what you typically have with very old, matured sherry cask whiskies, which typically have the same color than this one. This is, of course, uncolored, unchill filtered, as Signatory typically does with the high ABV bottlings. But it's a little bit closed. Not too much coming through. Yeah, now, darker fruits. What else with the sherry cask? A little bit oily. So I think we have to dilute it to bring out the real essence of this whiskey. Yeah. Now it opens up. Plums, figs, dates. And I'm astonished that this whiskey is tasting so old and not having these apple, pears, peaches, oranges, citrus, what you typically have in younger whiskies. So 10 years in first fill sherry butts. Is quite a time. Yeah, I think a little bit more would be suitable for this one. So, yeah, now a little bit more lighter fruitiness. You have to work with this. Cheers. Now it's juicy. It's grapefruit. Yeah, the cask is hitting. So the citrus has a light bitter note carrying on longer aftertaste for this. Together with what? I think now we have these peaches, nectarines. Yeah. Yeah. So it needs. Now the spiciness comes up my tongue. Yeah. This needs a second sip, really. Probably a third one. Now mouth-watering kicks in. Yeah. Stronger, more massive, lightly heating up, feeling in my mouth. Yeah. So this one needs more care than a typical one. So you have to find your way into this whiskey. What I'm not finding is caramel and vanilla. The cask is, from the dark fruitiness, is too intense. Yeah, so this is a bottling of a particular cask. So if you're looking around, find this bottle. The chances that you get one out of this particular cask is close to zero. So you have to be aware that these are single casks, no batches of casks mixed together, but single casks bottled. And this will lead to, varying tastes between the single batches or single casks. You have to be aware of that. And the bottle might not be that's affordable as you think. So this is a more expensive bottle. Yeah, let us stand this way. Thank you very much for watching. Stay tuned, there's more to come.